stripes, stinging like a bee. I earned my stripes. I went from zero to my own hero. You held me down, but I got up. Already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. Like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, cause I've had enough. I see it all, I see it now.
And welcome to the first edition of Around New Britain with Mayor Stewart of 2015. It's crazy to say that, but it's been a whole year. This show, I've been doing it for the past year. Its purpose serves to update you on the issues facing the city of New Britain. A big thank you goes out to Nutmeg Television for the opportunity and assistance in providing the public with these shows, and my producer, Joe Moreno, who is always here every month to make sure the show looks fabulous. These shows are also posted online on Nutmeg TV's website, on my YouTube channel, as well as all of their social media outlets. I made a commitment to the residents of the city of New Britain when I was elected way back in November of 2013 to make government more accessible and transparent to people. This show is just another step in opening that process to everybody in our community. I want you all to know that my office is always open to everyone, especially people seeking solutions to the problems that may face them on a daily basis. We might not be able to fix everything for you, but we can certainly point you in the right direction so that you can get the answers to the questions that you have. We do this through my office, by email, phone, through Twitter, Facebook, our city website at newbritainct.gov, or even in person once a month through my monthly open office hours. You can see my handles periodically at the bottom of your screen throughout the show. Feel free to visit me on any one of those outlets. This show also highlights the many programs and people that have a significant impact on our New Britain community. From former mayors to department heads to community organizations looking to change New Britain in a positive way, I'm looking to highlight what they do for our community and bring all that information right to you in your own living room. So I'm going to begin with my first segment, and that's titled, What's Happening in City Hall? For those of you watching that are interested, our next council meetings will be on Wednesday, January 14th and Wednesday, January 28th. As always, public participation starts at 7 p.m. The meeting begins at 7:30 unless public participation runs a little bit longer. It's important to note for any of you that may have business to be conducted here at City Hall, we will be closed on the following dates. We will be closed January 1st for New Year's Day, and we'll also be closed on January 19th. I want to take a moment to send a huge congratulations to our PAL kids. That's our Police Athletic League. Our cheerleaders, ages 11 to 14, placed first in the nation in the Pop Warner Championship in December in Florida. We are so, so proud of them. But in addition to them being top in the nation, our junior peewee cheer squad also won third place in the National Junior Peewee Level 2 Small Division Championship. And aside from the cheerleading program we have at PAL, our football program as well was extremely successful. Our young boys made it all the way to the Pop Warner National Championship. That game was televised live on ESPN2. And although they came up short in the end, I want everyone out there to know how proud we are of all of them. It's such an accomplishment to make it so far at such a young age. So we're going to honor our young sports stars at the January 14th council meeting. So tune in to Nutmeg TV on January 14th to meet our youngsters. Commission meetings that are coming up for the month. We've got Parks and Recreation meeting on January 8th at 6 p.m. in room 305. Updates include Go Ape, the program that we have talked about with the high ropes course, going to be put in Stanley Park. They'll be starting construction over the winter months, and as long as the weather holds up, they should be open for business by spring, by late spring and early summer. Definitely an exciting time for the parks, and we'll be somewhere to bring our kids to go and have fun enjoying the environment. At the Parks and Rec meeting, they'll also start talking about plans for the next Rose Garden Festival. That's starting to come underway. It will be held sometime in June. We haven't sealed a date yet, but don't worry, we'll keep you all posted. I know how much fun everybody had at the first annual Rose Garden Festival last year. The Commission for Community on Neighborhood Development will meet Thursday, January 8th at 6 p.m. in room 313. Our Zoning Board meets the third Thursday of the month. That'll be January 15th at 6 p.m. in room 201. The Commission on Animal Welfare will meet Tuesday, January 20th at 6 p.m. in room 305. And on their agenda is their first event, first annual Petsapalooza. They'll be talking about putting that event together and all the exciting things that will come along with it. That event's not going to be until July 15th from 5 to 9 p.m. at Walnut Hill, but we'll be updating you more on that as we seal up the details. The Arts Commission meets January 6th at 6:30 p.m. in room 305. One thing that the Arts Commission will be talking about this month is a little program called Art in the Heart of the City. So a couple years ago, it wasn't under my administration, the former Stewart administration, they started reaching out to local artists to put their work on display in City Hall, right outside of the mayor's office. You can see a piece of work right behind me to my right. I'll scoot over so you can check that out. But we are going to be doing our first big opening reception for Art in the Heart of the City the evening of the first council meeting in January on the 14th. Probably do it around 6 o'clock. But our next artist that will be put on the walls here is the CCSU Design Department. They'll be putting up a photo show for all of us to enjoy. We'll have that reception. I encourage all of you to come out. We'll be posting more information on that on the city website. I have a public works update for you. As you all know, we're getting into the winter season and everyone's favorite word, snow. I want to inform all of you that we have new snow plow routes that are in effect this year. We did some things a little differently. You can go online at newbritainct.gov and check out those new routes and where your street falls into. At the council meeting in December, we did pass the purchase of a software system. It's called RASTRAC. And that software system is the same system that New York City uses to be able to track all of their public works trucks. So we'll be able to follow and better manage our whole operation, our whole snow operation. We'll be able to see where our trucks are, how far along they are in their route. We'll be able to tell if your street has been plowed, if your street has been even salted. It's going to really bring our public works department into the 21st century, and we are very excited to hopefully bring that to the public for next winter. We've got to work out some kinks first in our public works department this year. So once we get all that figured out next year, we'll be able to have an online portal where you can log in at home and be able to see where our trucks are, where they've been, and when your street should be coming up next. But give us a year to figure out the kinks, and then next year we're going to make sure that you can have the ability to see how we're progressing, because you have a right to know. You're paying for the operation. The historic signage tour pieces are now online and available for public viewing on the city's website. I had talked a couple shows ago about the historic signage project, the historic signage walking tour. We have a few samples in the lobby of City Hall if anyone's interested in stopping by, or you can view them online and be able to read a little bit about what you'll learn on these historic walking tours. I have to thank everybody who was involved in garnering all the information and being able to put all that to paper. It's certainly not easy, but we're certainly looking forward to having our first tours come through in the spring, and I hope you'll all be joining some of us for them. I have an update for you on the Main Street Overpass. For those of you who don't know where that is, Main Street Overpass is, I guess the easiest way I can describe it is what connects Capital Lunch with Amato's. It's right where the Connecticut Fast Track station is going to be. We've been working very hard on plans to try to make that bridge more pedestrian friendly, a lot more beautiful, and make it appealing to drive over and walk over, as we understand that many people will be using that to get in and out of the Fast Track station. We have narrowed it down to two final designs. I want to thank our working group of city residents and stakeholders that we put together to be able to bring some of those ideas to the table. Excuse me. And we've got two designs. I think you're all gonna like them. We're really trying to capitalize on New Britain's past and where we'll be for the future. So they're very interesting. Some people think they're a little over the top, but I think it's going to be absolutely fantastic to bring that project to fruition. A Costco update. I'm sure I'll be talking about Costco until the day we cut that ribbon in the fall. But if anyone's driven by Hartford Road right next to Target, you'll see that all the brush and all the trees have been cleared away. They're working very hard on clearing that all and filling in the grade there, so they'll be able to start construction. That opening date is fall of 2015, so stay tuned. We just had a groundbreaking yesterday on Farmington Avenue for a new development that will be on the old Guida's ice cream site. I know that means so much to so many of you watching at home, but we have partnered with the Hunter Development Group to sell that parcel of land and develop it into, bear with me because there's quite a few things that are going to be on there. On the corner, there's going to be a Noble gas station with a Dunkin' Donuts drive-thru. Next to that, there's going to be what they're calling Frisbee's Dairy Barn. So this is going to be a new rendition of Guida's. The owners have made a commitment to work with Guida's to use all of their product to be able to make their own ice cream and have us have our families and children a great place to go after our baseball games. Our football games will be open all year round. We're very excited to be able to see that coming as well. Next to the Dairy Bar, there's going to be an additional building that's put, and I have heard rumblings that it may be an Italian restaurant, but we're still working out the deals on that. Being Italian myself, I certainly would like to see that there. Now, behind all that development, if you can picture, behind all of that, on Alexander Road, there's going to be a separate entrance to what's going to be a 65-bed memory care facility, specifically for dementia patients. That won't start until the spring. So there's two phases of this development: the gas station, the Dunkin' Donuts, and the ice cream place first. Then secondly, in the spring, they'll start on the restaurant building and the memory care facility down and back. So it's a very, very exciting time for New Britain. It's going to be a wonderful development to bring some more activity to that area of town. And the owner and developer is so committed to the city. He really wants to do as much as possible to give back, and we are happy, happy to do business with him. It is cold out there, so one more thing I'd like to mention. I know I mentioned this the last show. If anything does happen to you during those winter months, perhaps you lose power, maybe something goes wrong in the house, I don't know, things happen. We do have warming centers that are open all day at the New Britain Senior Center and the New Britain Public Library. You can feel free to take refuge there if you run into a situation. Our homeless shelter has also been opened for the winter months on Russell Street. A big thank you goes out to community mental health affiliates for opening their doors for our overflow population. Now I'm going to give you just a few events that are happening during the month of January, so bear with me for a few moments. I have to remind everybody that Tuesday, January 6th, we'll be celebrating Three Kings Day, the Epiphany, but we are having a citywide event on Tuesday, January 6th from 4 to 6 p.m. at McDonald's on West Main Street with their new owner, Joey Rodriguez. You see the flyer, you'll see them around town, I'm sure. They're having a special Three Kings Day celebration with three very special people dressed up as the Three Kings and perhaps a queen. You know, the Three Kings celebration is a sacred cornerstone of Latino holiday festivities. They foster an atmosphere of joy and giving in celebration of tradition of their cultural heritage. But most importantly, the Three Kings teach our children that values of sharing and caring in our community and preserving cultural traditions are very important. So to those of you who celebrate the Epiphany, I wish you a very peaceful holiday with you and your loved ones. That's on Tuesday, January 6th from 4 to 6 p.m. at the McDonald's on West Main Street. You'll see the flyers around town, I'm sure. On Monday, January 19th, the city of New Britain will be hosting a remembrance ceremony to celebrate the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. This happens every year at 10:45 a.m. on Monday, January 19th. That's at the Martin Luther King Monument located on Martin Luther King Drive. Everybody is invited to join us. We say we start at 10:45, but sometimes we don't start until a little later. We're all coming from a breakfast that we hold prior to that for our community leaders and church pastors and ministers. On Saturday, January 17th, from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m., the New Britain Industrial Museum right here in downtown will be opening an exhibit, New Britain at the 1904 World's Fair Exhibition. That will open on January 17th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m., and it'll run all the way through March 28th. And on Friday, January 23rd, from 10 to 11, at the Hole in the Wall Theater, they will be putting forth a drama that will run through Friday, February 14th, through Valentine's Day. It's called Through the Glass Darkly. There are a couple things that I do need to mention. Last month, we were very grateful to have an event called Wreaths Across America that was featured at Fairview Cemetery. I have to just send a big thank you out to all of the organizers of this event. Wreaths Across America is a nationwide celebration of our past veterans. And what they do is, in partnership with Walmart, they deliver thousands of wreaths, Christmas wreaths with red bows, to select cemeteries around the United States. And there's a wreath placed on each headstone, on each grave of a past veteran. Dennis Terracani, Dennis Budin, everybody who came together to make this event possible, thank you. There was an absolute wonderful community effort to bring all of our veterans units, our Hardware City Detachment, thank you so much, of the Marine Corps League. Their slogan and the motto for this year was Remember, Honor, Teach. A very important slogan to pass on to our children and our grandchildren, to always remember our fallen heroes, teach others about why it's important to remember them. I can't thank everybody enough, especially the New Britain High School students who helped create all of the stakes that were banged into the ground there to hang the wreaths on for those veterans who don't have a standing headstone. Highly suggest to take a drive by if you haven't seen it yet. It's absolutely stunning. I do want to give an update on the solar panels as well. I've been talking about City Hall going green for quite some time now. We're finally here. Smith Elementary School will be the first project to be complete. We're putting solar panels on the entire roof that will help power the school and help save us some more money on our energy bills. They started that project November 24th and finished it December 19th. So Smith is now all on our own powered energy. And yes, solar panels do work when it's cloudy, when it's snowing, and when it's raining. So we're looking forward to saving all of that money on our energy bills. The Smalley Elementary School started December 1st and finished December 29th. DeLoretto Elementary Middle School started December 15th and should be finishing early in January. And the last and biggest project is the water filtration plant up on Reservoir Road. That's planned to go from January 19th all the way up to the end of February. Because it is such a large project, we're still waiting on DPH for a permit approval from that, but we will be moving forward on that. All of the panels that we placed at the solar plant will help us power all of the pumps to get water to your homes directly. I also have to share some very exciting news because we are number one. Nutmeg TV, thank you for the email that you sent us the other day. They notified us that we are the number one most watched TV show on their network. So all of us here from around New Britain are very thankful to those of you who watch and are excited to what this new year can bring. Thank you for making us number one. So that's about all the time we have for today. Thank you again for joining us. A big thank you goes out to Mark Bernacki and the staff at the town clerk's office for all you do for our residents of the city. And I want to just take a moment to wish everybody a very happy and healthy 2015. All of you sitting at home making your New Year's resolutions, make sure they're ones that you can achieve. Don't just say you want to lose weight. Everybody says that. I like to say that every year too. But maybe do something, make it a point to have a resolution and do something nice for someone. Do something to give to others who may be less fortunate than you this year. I wish you all a very happy and healthy 2015. Thank you all for watching the show. I'm directing you to the bottom of the screen for our website, office number, and other ways to get more information about my office, more information regarding this show, and just ways to talk about the issues that affect you. I hope to see you all back next month for another edition of Around New Britain with Mayor Stewart.